in most cases where I'm involved in this early phase zero work, we're testing a device for the first time. We're looking at safety and how the device is going to interact.
Hey, Nick. In medical device development, we often head towards a regulatory submission that includes a clinical trial. And a lot of people think about these clinical trials kind of like at the last moment, but what do you all need to do before you are able to go into a clinical trial? What are the things that you have to think about beforehand?
Yeah, that's a great question. Yes, you really need to think about clinical trials before you do because, you know, it involves testing a new medical device in humans. And of course, you know, we're developing medical devices. Human safety is kind of job number one, right?
Absolutely.
And that is no more true than when we're testing out a brand new product in humans, and we do what we call human clinical trials. Here at Starfish, I have the privilege and the honor of getting to work with clients developing human clinical trials, and I get to even help design some of those trials in my job here. And so I'm acutely aware of this question.
Yes, yes.
So I guess what I'll do is I'll, to answer your question, I'll tell you a little bit about the clinical trial process. And typically what we do here is when we're about to test a device in an early human clinical trial, and in most cases where I'm involved in this early phase zero work, we're testing a device for the first time. We're looking at safety and how the device is gonna interact. So we can have a whole other episode about different types of clinical trials, but I'll focus in that space for today. So in that case, what I typically do is I'll engage with what we call a contract research organization, or a CRO. And that CRO, they're typically an expert in that medical device space. They're gonna know all the test procedures. They're gonna have clinicians, clinical staff that are well equipped and acquainted with that type of device. So there's a level of expertise that's there. They in turn will work with a clinical site, and that clinical site will have what they call an IRB, or an institutional review board. And that review board will look at the device and the procedures that we're attempting to do, and they'll look at safety, efficacy, any types of risk. If it's very risky, and if we're doing a trial here in Canada, we'll have to file what's called an ITA, or Investigational Testing Authorization through Health Canada. Health Canada will get involved, they'll look at the device and say, yep, that's safe to do, or we need to rethink that one. In the US, we'll do what's called an IDE, or an Investigational Device Exemption, and that'll allow that device to be used in the trial. The trials that we do are typically fairly small groups of people, less than 15 or so, and what we will look at is, and even before we do that, one of the key things is that each person involved in that trial has what's called informed consent. They will be, the CRO usually does this, and they'll explain in excruciating detail what the potential risks are of the device, how we're mitigating that, and so that, you know, if you or I were to participate in it, we'd feel safe in understanding that everything's gonna be okay.
And there's a form that you have to sign.
There's exactly right. Dating way back to the Declaration of Helsinki, that's where this comes from. You have to fill out the form and sign and make sure everybody is square on that. And then of course, the trial has to be conducted under what we call GCP, or good clinical practice. And there's very specific guidelines that have to be followed. Again, another good episode that we can talk about on that one. All the results have to be documented, and there has to be final reporting. And that is how, essentially, you do a clinical trial.
Lots of considerations,
not something you've done lightly, but very important in the development process, for
sure. Yeah, absolutely. Invaluable data, and absolutely required for a regulatory submission as well.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Cool.
Well, that was the end of BioBreak. Have a great day.
Have a great day.